top of the inner barrel, a low-friction, tough polymer stud fits into a spiral channel on the inside of the focus ring. Just like on a regular camera, as this turns, the inner barrel slides forwards and backwards. This moves the glass discs inside to give a razor-sharp focus. Inside a metal ring sit 8 overlapping stainless steel leaves, just 2/1000ths of an inch thick. Miniature pivots link them together to form a circular pattern. As the ring turns, it opens and closes the leaf formation, changing the size of the hole at the center. Just one smooth motion controls the exact amount of light entering the camera.
Let us introduce you to the new Masson Steady 8-axis hybrid camera stabilizer. Of this test video is to show you how easy and comfortable it is to work with this new hybrid camera stabilizer. If you're looking for epic camera movements to improve your shots, let's check out this test video. When we first built this new 8-axis hybrid camera stabilizer, we wanted to create a simple and reliable stabilization solution change the typical Steadicam, to redefine camera stabilization forever. We also wanted to simplify the learning process of becoming a professional steady operator. To put into the hands of any kind of filmmaker the most advanced hybrid electromechanic stabilizer. We're excited to see what professional filmmakers can do with this amazing product. As you walk with this new stabilizer, the new isolation arm absorbs the unwanted bumps. As well, it works to smoothly roll up and down the camera. The comfortable vest will also distribute the weight through your body, letting you work for longer periods of time, all day, with a noticeably reduced fatigue. The rotary head takes control of the horizontal level and also controls the tilt of the camera, creating a perfect cinematic shot. So you just need to pan your camera and set the desired height of the rotary head to frame your shot. You can also rotate your camera 360 degrees from high mode to low mode without losing stabilization. No more blind spots. Constant viewing of the LCD monitor, even while rotating the steady on any axis. Powered with silent motors, it's so quiet, you can now use the audio from the camera mic. Redefining camera stabilization forever. It's ready to use. Just press on. The other secret as well, along with all stabilizers, is how you walk. This hybrid stabilizer will control the 4 dimensions of movement, but you can still help with just a few simple tricks. To move smoothly without going up and down, keep your knees bent as well as your elbows to act as a suspension. Try also to emulate the ninja walking style while keeping an eye on your monitor to frame your shot. By following these simple tips, you will get the most out of your steady. With a little practice, you will gain endurance and coordination. So with confidence, you can start thinking about running or walking through stairs as well as moving through narrow spaces. The rotary head gives you the chance to shoot with smaller cameras, such as Micro Four Thirds or DSLRs, as well as with professional cameras, such as Red Epic or Alexa Mini. Fantastic shots like never before with this new 8-axis hybrid camera stabilizer. Move around freely in narrow spaces without drawbacks. can achieve a natural freedom of movement. If you are already a professional steady operator, this new stabilizer is like a dream come true. Now, it's your move. Find out what a Vasson Steady can do for you.
House every weekend, and if I don't get it, slow down for you, Paul. Oh? Yeah.
Is it control?
Yeah, I don't think it's feeling.
It's not gonna take a break now. Ah.
Oh, stop! What am I?
When it comes to
Y las dos secciones ya las llevaba emparejaditas. Eso fue lo último que vimos. Su apunte debe estar. Estábamos en grupo de presión, ¿hasta dónde llegamos con ustedes?
Hasta la tipología del grupo de presión. Bueno, los grupos.
¿Ah?
La tipología del grupo de presión.
Yo dejé el cuerno.
¿Qué es eso?
Psicología del grupo de presión.
Tipología.
Ah. Obviamente utilizar un medio no convencional, ilícito y legal, como es justamente evitar el derecho al libre tránsito de alguien. O generar violencia abierta, rompiendo propiedades públicas, prendiendo fuego. ¿Ah? Bueno, como vemos la semana pasada, romper bienes públicos, paralizar el tráfico, es decir, medios de violencia, que es una manera de presionar al centro de decisión política, creando una suerte de desorden social, de caos, de problemas para que las autoridades intervengan. Entonces, suelen ser los grupos de presión, bueno, estos llamados grupos anómicos que vimos en la tipología, bueno, justamente entran en esa categoría. Muchas veces también los estudiantes tradicionalmente, por eso en la actual movimiento estudiantil se está diferenciando de eso, lo estamos viendo como ayer, un recurso muy sofisticado como es por una vía pacífica y legal presentar un documento ante el Tribunal Supremo Constitucional. Cuando tradicionalmente lo que hacía el movimiento estudiantil, aquí en Venezuela vivimos años de años en la universidad, el famoso fenómeno de los encapuchados, que era salir de las tres gracias y enfrentar a la policía y empezaban, bueno, lo primero en la procedimiento era siempre el mismo, se repetía una y otra vez. Paraban cualquier camioneta cargada, cualquier producto, hacían que el conductor se bajara, por supuesto iban encapuchados, los jóvenes le prendían fuego a la camioneta, bueno, ahí mismo aparecía la metropolitana, acordonaba la zona y entonces empezaba la batalla campal entre encapuchados y policía. Bueno, ahí tenemos un procedimiento de violencia que utilizaban casi siempre, bueno, los sectores estudiantiles.